easily one of the most important calculations that you're going to learn in the first semester of general chemistry is being able to convert between grams, moles, and number of atoms. And to be able to do this, we need two things. We need the molar mass of whatever we're dealing with, and also we need Avogadro's number. So remember, molar masses are in grams per mole. Avogadro's number is in atoms per mole. And remember, this can be in molecules per mole too, depends on if we're talking about atoms or molecules. And the idea is we really use molar mass and Avogadro's number as a type of conversion unit. The same way I can go from centimeters to meters, I can go from grams to moles to number of atoms. And so this is the basic diagram. And if you see this, we can go from one side to the other. If I take grams and I divide by the molecular weight, that will give me moles. If I take moles of something and divide by, or excuse me, if I take moles of something and multiply by Avogadro's number, that will tell me how many atoms are in that number of moles. Likewise, if I take the number of atoms of something and divide by Avogadro's number, it tells me how many moles I have. And if I take the number of moles of something and multiply by the molar mass, that gives me the number of grams of that. And of these, we may refer to the number of atoms, but really this first one is the one that we're going to see the most in general chemistry. Grams divided by molecular weight gives moles. Moles times molecular weight gives grams. In this example, I've been given 8 grams of carbon, and I need to find out how many moles of carbon are in there. So I have grams, and I want to find moles. So what I need to do is to be able to divide by the molar mass of carbon. So I go to the periodic table and I grab that. Molar mass of carbon, 12.00 or 0.011 grams per mole. I take the grams of carbon, divide by the molar mass. That tells me that there is 0.67 moles of carbon in the 8 grams of carbon. So then I say, how many carbon atoms are in that 0.67 mole of carbon? So here I have moles, I want to go to atoms. That means I need to multiply by Avogadro's number. So I take my 0.67 mole, multiply by Avogadro's number, that tells me I have 4.0 times 10 to the 23rd carbon atoms. And so we can go the other way, and a lot of the times they have you go completely in one direction. So here we're starting with atoms and we're going all the way to mass, or the number of grams. I give you a certain number of oxygen atoms and I say, what's the mass of those oxygen atoms? The first thing I need to do is find out how many moles of my oxygen atoms that I have. So in order to find the weight of something, I need the molar masses in grams per mole, so I need moles. So the first thing I do is I take the number of atoms, I divide by Avogadro's number, and that's going to give me moles. So here we have the number of oxygen atoms. I divide by Avogadro's number, that tells me how many moles that we have. Next, that once I have the number of moles, I multiply by the molar mass of oxygen. So I get that off the periodic table, 16.00 grams per mole. I multiply by the number of moles I have by the molar mass. That tells me how many grams of oxygen that I have.